हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू साइंस क्लास। दिस इज अकमल हुसैन, लेक्चरर जूलॉजी, स्क्वायर हाई स्कूल एंड कॉलेज। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ए जूलॉजी क्लास ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8, चैप्टर 1। Today's topic is classification of animal world. Chapter 1, name classification of animal world. The world is inhabited by numerous diverse small and large animals. There are various similarities and dissimilarities among them. From microscopic amoeba to the gigantic whale, all are included in this diverse world of animals. Some of them live on land, some in water, and some on trees. So far, about 1.5 million species of animals have been discovered, and the number is increasing day by day. It is very tough to memorize the characteristics of total animal world. That's why Aristotle, John Dee, Cavellus, Linnaeus try their best to classify them, and they are notable names in the history of classification. What is classification? Classify something is called classification. What is animal classification? Classification is a system to classify animals on the basis of their characteristics. Or we may say, classification is an easy way to know the structure and nature of animals. Cavellus Linnaeus is called the father of taxonomy. In the naming of animals, he introduced binomial nomenclature and defined genus and species. Scientific name is an animal contains two parts. The process of this such naming is called binomial nomenclature or scientific name. For example, Homo sapiens is the scientific name of human. Scientific name must be in Latin or Latinized language. Classification of kingdom Animalia, that means total animal is in kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia divided into 9 phylum: Porifera, Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, and Chordata. Then phylum Chordata divided into 3 subphylum: number 1 Urochordata, number 2 Cephalochordata, number 3 Vertebrata. Again, subphylum Vertebrata divided into 7 classes: Cyclostomata, Condychthys, Osteichthys, Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves, and Mammalia. Phylum 1, the member phylum 1 named Porifera. The member of the phylum Porifera is commonly known as sponge. General characteristics of Porifera: number 1, simplest multicellular animal, body wall with numerous pores. Through these pores, food and oxygen enter into the body. No compact tissue, organ, or organ system developed. That's why such kind of animals is called simplest multicellular animal. Example, Spongilla, Scypha, etc. There are two pictures of Porifera. Phylum 2, Cnidaria. The previous name of Cnidaria is Coelenterata. general characteristics of cnidaria. Number one, body consists of two embryonic layers. What is embryonic layers? Most of the animals, in their embryonic condition, there are two or three layers. These are called embryonic layers. Here, this type of animal consists of two embryonic layers. The outer one is ectoderm and the inner one is endoderm. Body cavity known as cylinderon. It helps in digestion and circulation. Number three, ectoderm bears a special type of cells called nidoblast. These cells help in locomotion, defense, capture of prey. Example, Hydra, Obelia, Aurelia, etc. This is a picture of Aurelia or jellyfish. This is a picture of Hydra. Phylum 3, Platyhelminthes. General characteristics of Platyhelminthes. Body flat. Their body is flatted dorsoventrally. Bisexual and mostly parasitic. Bisexual, that means they are not divided into male and female member. And mostly parasitic. They depend for their food and nutrition on other animal. Ectoparasitic or endoparasitic. Ectoparasitic, that means when they live on outside of the host body. Endoparasitic or endoparasite, when they live inside of the body of host. Body covered with thick cuticle. Body bears sucker and hooks. Phloem cell present and acting as excretory organ. They are not developed animal. That's why their excretory organ is not developed. A special type of cell named phloem cell, and phloem cell act as excretory organ. Digestive system incomplete or absent. Example, liver fluke, tapeworm, etc. Picture of liver fluke. Picture of tapeworm. Phylum 4, Nematoda. General characteristics of Nematoda. Number 1, body tubular, that means cylindrical, and covered with thick skin. Digestive system complete. Mouth and anus present. When in any animal mouth and anus present, then we say that digestive system is complete. When only mouth present, anus is absent, is called digestive system incomplete. Respiratory and circulatory system absent. Generally unisexual, that means here male and female is divided. Female member and male member. Two types of members are present in this group. Body cavity without lining and true coelom absent. Example, roundworm, filaria worm, etc. This is the picture of roundworm. Love the animals. Thank you.